Hello everyone, it's Helder here, and today I wanted to talk a bit about my Comet tri-band antenna. We had a few of our members at Natural Training Center ask me to review it. I've been using it now for a couple years. As I stated, it's made by Comet. It is an SBB-224 antenna. And I also have the actual bracket here, or the mounting bracket, that's also made by Comet. It is an RS-730. All right, once again, I've had this on here for a couple years, so there's a little bit of wear on here. I have not taken it off, all right? So whether the weather is bad or the elements are bad, I still end up keeping it on here. What I do have is I ended up choosing this mount because I didn't want to put any holes in the truck. This was more of a temporary setup that's lasted a couple years, of course. All right, so once again, what I do is if I am someplace, and let's say it's even a shady area and I'm worried about the antenna, what I end up doing is I had these aluminum fishing poles, all right, where I store my fishing poles so that I could just throw them in here and nothing breaks. And I also have a PVC one, and the antenna ends up fitting perfectly in here. So once again, the aluminum special here from Cabela's for the fishing pole works great. If you want to save some money and do it all for a couple bucks, just pick up a piece of PVC and a couple end caps, and you are good to go. Okay, so we have the inside now of the Jeep setup. What I do use is my trusty Yaesu VX8DR tri-band radio. And once again, I mainly use it for UHF and VHF communications. And I like being portable, I like being mobile, and also cost-effective. I like having this radio with me, and of course, with all the options. The one thing that I do have here is a cap that comes with the Comet mounting bracket that I had showed you back there. So when I do take the antenna off, I can go ahead and just screw this cover in, just a little bit of threading, and that protects the actual connection from the elements. And that comes standard with the mounting bracket that I had shown you earlier. So once I do get in, I usually have my diamond tri-band rubber ducky on my Yaesu. And what I have here is similar to what I showed you before. I made a smaller PVC, actually one of my friends made this for me, and just very simple piece of PVC pipe and two end caps. So we end up just taking out the end cap, taking off the diamond antenna, putting it in here, covering the cap, and we are good to go. I could throw this in my pack. I can go ahead, throw it anywhere in the car, and know that even if people step on it or the dog step on it or whatever the case may be, my antenna's protected. All right, so that's always something to think about. You want to be able to take care of your gear and maintain it so that it's ready to use when you're ready to use it. The other thing that I use inside the vehicle is a battery eliminator. Okay, I picked this one up on eBay. I'll leave links to where I purchased everything and where you can get it. It says here that it's made by the Yaesu Musen company. All right, so that's a good thing, made in Japan. So even though this did come from China, it seems to be good to go on the specs itself. All right, so I use that in here. I end up getting the full, or pretty close to the 5 watts from my Yaesu radio when I do have this hooked up, okay? And what I'm gonna do is, once I do store the antenna, what I did is in the center console here, okay, I ended up running the wires that you saw coming from the antenna in the back, all right, coming into here, and then going into my small SMA connector that'll mount right to the antenna bracket here, or the antenna SMA mount on the Yaesu itself. All right, so just an easy way, because then once I do have it attached, I can always just store it in here. If I need to run in and do something or go somewhere, I don't have to worry about the safety or the radio being exposed for somebody to be able to see it and maybe want to grab it. So it's kind of cool that I can just kind of throw everything in the center console where it's ran here, okay, with the 259 connector that's coming in, and then mating to the actual wire that's going to go to my SMA connector. So let me get that all hooked up for you now. Okay, so I have everything set up here. I have my battery eliminator hooked up to the DC outlet in the car, all right, or the cigarette lighter for us older folks. Okay, I have the Yaesu hooked up. I have the antenna hooked up to the SMA connector. As you could tell, I have the APRS on, and it's receiving beacons. Another thing great about this antenna that I haven't really spoken about is its performance. It's hard for me to get APRS or really get them sent out using the rubber ducky. Once I do get into the Jeep and hook up the Comet, it's right away, as you could tell, the beacons are being sent, being received, and I've been able to hit digit repeaters 25 miles away or so. Hopefully I could put the actual APRS.fi screen up, because that only happened a couple weeks ago, so pretty much every time from here I'm always hitting that repeater. But once again, only with this Comet antenna, so the performance on it is outstanding, okay? When it comes to APRS and when it comes to pretty much everything else, I've been very happy with that. And what I do is I have the local repeater tuned in here, so I want to go ahead and just send a test call. Just so that you can see, you can tell the APRS signals are being sent out. So once again, let me go ahead and send out that call. W2NTC testing.
K2ZV, repeat.
Okay, so we're pretty good to go on here. So there's plenty of ways to mount this radio. Once again, you could tell the antenna is just coming here from the center console. I could give myself more of a lead, or I could kind of tuck it in and give myself less of a lead. The cup holder, pretty good to go. Once again, I'm able to check it at red lights and stop signs. And once again, I don't do too much switching around when I'm on the road anyway. That's obviously very dangerous. So, once again, having the two stations that I want being monitored. When I do get a chance, I'm able to switch that. And once again, the more practice you have with your radio, the easier that it becomes. All right. So once again, here is the battery eliminator hooked up. All right. I have the external speaker. Okay. Or the speaker mic external hooked up here. All right. What I like about having it hooked up here on the visor is that it has the GPS unit. All right. That's sending out the locations and feeding the information for APRS. So that's up here nice and high, and I seem to get a pretty good signal on there fairly often. And once again, there's all sorts of different ways to mount. This is all your personal preference, how you use it and what works for you. With this Comet antenna, it's amazing the way that it does perform. It's a lot more than what I thought. It performs very similar to any base antenna, and the fact that I can be mobile, which totally fits into my lifestyle, really impresses me with this Comet antenna. It was definitely worth every penny. Once again, reaching repeaters and stations, miles away that I would never think I could even listen in, let alone being able to actually transmit and communicate to them. So this is definitely not a toy when it comes to an antenna. And this just setup I'm very happy with. And I'm sure if you go ahead and choose this antenna, I don't think you'll have any complaints whatsoever for a while. Like I said, it's been a couple years, so it's not like I just picked it up and I'm reviewing it now, so I have plenty of experience, and it's definitely good to go. All right, so that's pretty much the review for the Comet and how it's integrated into my Jeep for mobile and portable use. Once again, Helder, W2NTC, 73s.